Welcome back to Living on the Ocean, episode 019 already. And indeed, she was steering very heavy, and that's what we're gonna change. Cheryl was steering with everything she had, holding the tiller between her legs, and often it was impossible and I had to take over. And it was not just Cheryl not being strong enough. The autopilot, in the first 2 hours, the plastic head on the end broke off by the forces that this rudder generated. This aluminium and stainless steel combined rudder on the back of the transom of Dawn, in a kind of V shape on the back, had a blade in it that could not swing backwards if it hit something. And here on this picture from Trimaran Twilight, the same kind of setup, the rudder hanging in a V, and that's actually quite a good idea, I like it. But the rudder is actually not longer hanging behind the boat, those are the last bits of the hinges, the rudder pins broke. And actually, they already were quite bad for a long time, and that's the hard thing to see with stainless steel. Now in episode 5 I already told this story and how helicopters wanted to rescue me, but I will put up a link for those that haven't seen it. The rudder blade is taken off and dropped on the sandbank. And we can start now the process of building something much better. So we designed a carbon fiber system for Trimaran Dawn. Basically the same as we've done for Trimaran Twilight, just a bit bigger. And with foam we make the blade a much better shape for this boat. We make it a bit deeper, since it's not longer going up and down but only swings backwards. We reinforce it with carbon fiber. We make that all nice and smooth, and we definitely make sure that it has a counterbalance area to steer lighter. And it's already built so we can put a trim tab in it, but for now we closed it because we want to get this boat sailing and start an adventure. We can always do that later to the rudder. And with a bit of fun with a carbon pipe, I make the possibility for wheels on the back of this rudder blade just above the waterline to guide the ropes that are going to hold this rudder blade tight in its housing when it's done. Without molds, the end job is plastering, and sanding to get to look it very nice and very smooth. And that's possible, it just takes patience. I've put tape for cardboard boxes on the top of this rudder blade. Epoxy doesn't stick to it, and I can build a very tight fitting housing around it now. First with only a very thin layer of glass fiber. And when that's done, I start to draw all the carbon fiber reinforcement and positions for hinges on it. It's nice weather outside, and a very thin strip of foam is used to glue around the edge of this housing for the rudder, and then filled up with a filler of epoxy filler. Now this rudder housing is ready for carbon fiber. It worked out nice, and I can plan where the ropes come, and I can plan the position for a knot on the inside. But I need space for that, and that's where the blue dot is for. To put the carbon fiber on, I must put it back on the rudder blade to make sure that it gets the exact shape. I put the carbon fiber just over the edges of the foam to be trimmed off later perfectly. Now it's time to build a carbon fiber tube for the hinges. I've put 2 layers of baking foil around an inox pipe. 2 layers so they can slide over each other, else you have a lot of trouble getting the pipe off. And I've held those layers of baking foil together with plastic tape. I wet the right length of carbon fiber tape, first with epoxy before I wind it around the pipe. And then I wet plastic silicone foil very tight around it. Because no peel ply was used, a little bit of sanding later is necessary to get a good connection. It's always nice to have peel ply around, but in this case it wasn't there and it can be done without. With the help of a bit of wood and 2 round holes in it, a little mold is made to keep this pipe in exactly the same place, while the carbon tubes around it are curing in the perfect position on top of this housing for the new rudder blade. The big challenge is to make sure that no epoxy gets in between and it's going to stick this pipe quite permanently to the tubes. And that's the big excitement for the next day. Does it come out? The next day when the epoxy is cured and I've taken away all the tape, It's the moment of truth. Will the pipe come out? Now, having done my work quite securely and having done it before, it worked. And there's the pipe. Yes! Now it's by far not finished yet, because a lot more work needs to be done. The pipes are only put in place with a bit of carbon fiber now. It needs to be nicely filled out, and then with UD tapes of carbon fiber over it, it needs to be glued very strong to the sides. But for now, it was a very nice job. Being back with living on the ocean and making new footage of what we are doing with Trimaran Dawn and Trimaran Twilight is fantastic, and thank you for watching our channel and subscribing. It's been a great encouragement to both of us. But where did we go in 2021 when we needed a break? As some of you warmed our hearts by saying that you missed us.